Hey, what's going on, wonderful family out there, YouTube family, family of human beings, everywhere spread across this globe. One day I'm gonna show you exactly already at this stage how many of you are from so many different places, and I couldn't be happier. You're wonderful, you choose to spend some time, maybe you're in a bus, on the scooter, in the car. Don't look at your phone while you're driving, only if you're a passenger, or also if you're on the scooter, better you keep both hands on the steering wheel. And maybe you're in your bedroom. I don't want to know what you were doing. Perhaps you were doing your thing, your bowel movement in the morning, and you choose, all right, I'm gonna watch some Frank Varchilia video. I forgive you because I don't feel the smell, and that's fine. And let's go dive straight into another reaction. We are 81,000 of us. You're pretty awesome. You're pretty awesome. I'm gonna do a live soon. I'm trying to make a tradition every so often to thank you guys for your support. I mean it. I truly mean it. Let's get out of the strange character for a second, even though that's me and my imaginary butler right there. We are just like this. But every now and then, we have to pretend that we are normal people. So, I just wanted to thank you. Super awesome of you guys to support the channel. And we're growing. We keep growing. Share it with everybody. Make flyers. Spread it around. Whatever. Do whatever you like. Anyway, before I lose the thread of the conversation, which I really did, let's go together and do this. It's all improvised anyway. And we give cringe material for the future. Yes. Commercial. The only reason why I bear you, it's because pays. Not me, but I know the commercial pays. Lyrics right here. I don't know why I feel like this beginning of a song sounds a little bit like I don't know, a CEO is coming out and he's going like, this year in 2020, we have worked tirelessly the whole year to bring you this new experience. Well, I see flat screen, so this is fairly recent. Hey. Mujer tremenda. Oh, nice. Oh, that's a really interesting. This song is way more indie than I would have imagined, actually. Also, the type of vocal melody line that she's using, pretty entertaining, I have to say. And also unexpected for me. Volume, volume. Wow. The abismo de su corazón. I assume it's, she means the depth of his heart. He opened up the depth of his heart. All right, she's having a little bit of trouble there with the microphone and the monitor in her ears, and with the volume. And here I'm trying to follow the lyrics. And this time I didn't translate. I just want to see what I understand. Wow. I Maybe. Well, she's having trouble with that, but she is having no trouble belting like a queen. Impressive, incredibly impressive. And this song is so much more rock. I like it. You broke my illusion with stones. My king was a stone monster, right? Con el corazón de piedra, with the heart of stone. Wow. I really like this part that she's doing this vocalizing. Super nice. The king. Wow. I love that the king was a stone monster. It was a monster. I love the power and the way she's delivering those very, really, really dramatic lines, you know, con el corazón de piedra, su amor siempre fu mentira, Castillo que hoy son ruinas, also the part before where she goes and says, where is that, the king, he broke, I paid my love with stones, and he broke my illusion with stones. I was once that naive, faithful. Wow. And she's just belting all those lines out with that urgency and desperation, which you really empathize with that. So that feels like really she has gone through that. Wow, what a rocker. I love that. Wow, I want to listen to this again. This scream belting is just awesome. Yes. Wow. Ooh, we got Slash. Slash without conditioner. He just came out of the shower like poof. I love those hair, man. They're both very curly. Alright, the poor dude. Para volver e amar. We're not gonna do that, right? We're not gonna do that, right? I don't know why I suggested there. The poor dude, he just wanted to go on with a little bit more solo. This is the rockers, the rockiest song I've heard of her, and I have to say I really like it. I really enjoyed it. Apart from, of course, the introspectional experience of again coming to the conclusion that law wasn't worth it, of the illusion that she's portraying that was broken, and awareness kicks in, and then you have to metabolize that awareness and you write a song in order to overcome the mistake of the past. So far, so good. And yeah, that's why we got music. That's why we got heart. She really feels like that she went through those things. Anyway, if you want to see more Amanda, let me know. Go check out the other video. And if you want, subscribe. We don't only talk about music here, but I also share my music and my covers and stuff. So you got more things to watch. I'll see you later. Is that weird enough? It's weird enough. It is.